I reached a room without any exits. I started spinning around in a frenzy, scanning my surroundings, searching for the source of that sound that only existed in my head. This melody was like an illness that slowly started to consume me, taking me into insanity. The insanity that came from the depths. Relying entirely on my instincts, I started hammering my fists desperately against the concrete floor. Little by little, bits started to come off, revealing a tunnel. Only a madman would dare go into an area the doctor herself had abandoned for some reason. But I had no choice. Away from the other tunnels, I came across a strange room. It was a banquet hall, preceding a cell which had a door at the back. It was odd. Even though my stomach still turns whenever I recall the image I'll describe, I have to say, I had a feeling of relief at the time. How long had it been since I had come across something non-painful? Right in front of my eyes, displayed on a rustic wooden table, there was an abandoned feast. Loads and loads of leftovers from an absurd amount of now rotten food. All that waste was covered in a thick fluid, much like animal saliva, which emanated an unspeakable stench. It was intolerable. There was no mistake. That meal had been laid out for someone or something voracious and non-human. Psychic signal is so strong, it's corroding my brain. I don't know if these memories are mine anymore. It feels like my identity was being tainted. With every step I take, I can see and feel her victim's terror. I can perceive her cruelty, her madness. Her devotion fascinates me, seduces me, and excites me. I must stop her. Or stop.
Thank you.
Behind the abandoned facade, a wide and neat hallway led the way to a fancy research center. The walls were so white, they made my vision blurry. I could feel it. The doctor was still inside the building.